Hello everyone, it's Leo, and in this video we're going to talk about the next few episode titles for Tropical Rouge Precure in the spooky month of October. Yes, spoilers, we are going to have a Halloween episode. Yes, it is happening this time around, but let's talk in order. As we're entering the realm of the solo character episodes, we are obviously going to start the batch of episodes from October with an Oscar episode this weekend, and next weekend we're gonna have a Sango episode. Yes, episode 32 is gonna be called Run for the Runway, Sango's Fashion Show. I absolutely love this name. It kind of gives me Hardcatch Precure vibes with a fashion show. We had that amazing episode in Hardcatch with Heart Goes On. I love that song. Oh my God. And I feel like in this episode, we're going to see a lot of growth from Sango. We've met her at the start, that quiet girl who doesn't really speak her mind, who's always timid and, you know, she just wants to blend in. She never really wants to be who she is. And now with the Tropical Club, she's learning how to do that. We saw that in episode 29. So I'm episode... Yes, 29, that great episode, yes. And so I'm pretty excited for this one. I'm pretty sure this is going to be a gorgeous episode. All of the episodes that kind of focused on Sango were very nice, and I'm pretty sure this one is going to be very nice as well. Well, we had a Minori episode. We kind of had a Manatsu episode. I mean, the Power Up episode kind of focused on her. We had a Laura episode, and now we're getting an Asuka episode and a Sango episode. Let's complete the solo episode saga. I feel like solo episodes for Tropical Rouge are something very rare for all of the characters, and it usually focuses more on the group as a whole, and as in Laura's relationship with the girls and different people, because that's part of Laura's story and storyline as her being the queen and everything. But now I'm loving those solo episodes. I feel like Asuka's episode will be the bomb and Sango's episode will be fire as well. Now let's talk about episode 33, which is going to be called Viva! Tenpiece the Tropical. I have no idea what to expect from this episode based on the episode title. I wonder if in this episode we're getting the other Heart Kururing, the Marine Heart Kururing, to see the other attack and the from the power-up form. I don't think we are, but I have no idea what to expect from this episode. It feels very like party-like, carnival-like, just because of the word Viva. Yes, I know, but that's the only thing I can get from this. And I'm pretty excited for this nonetheless, and I feel like the title is very fun, just like Tropical Rouge as a whole, so I'm just excited. In episode 34, we have Dreams Are Infinite. What are you going to be when you grow up? So I feel like this is another, it's going to be another one of the group episodes, kind of like episode 33 as well. And now we're entering more on the realm of what the girls want to do in the future. This is one of the things that Precure works on a lot in lots of character-driven stories. Usually the character-driven stories are more related towards what they want to be in the future, what job they want to have, and who they want to be. And Tropical Rouge did not really focus on that at all. And now they're doing an episode just for that, maybe to set it up for the last episode so that we can see them in the future in those specific professions or what they actually want to be in their future lives. So I'm very curious, what do you think each of the girls are going to choose? I'm pretty sure Manatsu has no idea what she wants to do. Laura will still want to hold on to the dream of being the queen. Minori probably a writer. Sango, I think Sango will want to inherit the store from her mother or maybe do something else with makeup. I would love if she chose like something like Nikki tutorials, you know, on YouTube and become a makeup guru on YouTube. I would love to see her doing something like that. I feel like it works a lot with her personality because she is shy, but at the same time, she always wants to blossom. She always wants to shine. So I feel like that would be very interesting. And Asuka, I have no idea what to expect from Asuka. I don't even know. Maybe something related to sports. I have no idea. I have no idea. What do you think? What is your idea for Asuka? I love Asuka so much, but I can't really think of an occupation for her that she would love or she would dream to be like. But I don't know. I just love Asuka nonetheless. And I feel like this is another episode in which we might see more of Laura in relation to her dream of becoming the queen. Maybe she's going to start questioning herself more. Am I fit for this role? What do I have to do to become a better queen or a better queen candidate? I feel like this is going to play out. And I'm pretty sure we're going to have very funny moments, because I feel like this is going to be done in school. Maybe as an application in school, they're going to have to talk about that. Just imagine Laura talking to the school about being, about wanting to become the queen in the future. That would be iconic. And obviously, let's talk about episode 35, which is going to be called Exciting Halloween, Don't Lose Manatsu. We're finally getting a Halloween episode again. We had one in Star Twinkle 2 years ago. It was awesome. It's an episode that I absolutely love to see the girls, you know, dressing up and, you know, becoming someone else. And I love the fact that Yuni didn't need to dress up. She just became her real self, and it played out as if she were someone else. I love this. And we had the Mihoshi stars. Oh my god, this episode was everything. I love it. And I'm pretty sure we're gonna have another very fun episode with Manatsu as well, with the tropical girls. And I wonder who they're gonna dress up as and everything. So I'm pretty excited for this episode as well. And for a Halloween episode, because, you know, we didn't have one last year. It's totally understandable, but now we're getting one. Spooky October is in session, and Tropical Rouge is not gonna be out of it. No. It's gonna play out very nicely in Tropical Rouge. So I feel like October is gonna be a very strong month for this season, and I'm really loving, after they got the power up, everything seems to be very, very strong. I mean, we just had two episodes, and but even before that, with the Minori episode, gosh, what a great episode we had with Minori. Wow, it was incredible. I love it. And I really like how Tropical Rouge works with its characters, so I wonder how these next few episodes are gonna go. Which one are you the most excited for? I am personally most excited for episode 34, Their Dreams of Growing Up. I'm very curious to learn more about who they want to be and everything else. But what about you? I'm gonna be very honest. I'm also very excited for Coral's episode, or Sungo's episode, and that the tropical episode. I mean, what are they gonna do? What's gonna happen in that? I'm curious and I'm excited, and I just want to enjoy Tropical Rouge because it's being gorgeous. It's being a lot of fun. Anyways, guys, that was it. Please leave a comment with your episode of choice. Which one is making your heart go doki doki? Thank you so much for watching, and special thank you to all the members of the Magical Cinnamon channel. If you are a member, thank you very, very much for your support and for standing by me. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, bye-bye.